Welcome to the Spirit of Life channel. Please subscribe, like, comment and share. Thank you so much. The message begin right now. The one closest to you, greetings. 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 My beautiful beings of light. The rays of brilliance are gleaming from your crown chakras as you read these pages. Again we gather to celebrate you, the universe's divine light warriors of grace. The Creator surrounds each of you with a protective blanket of white light laced with the highest of pink love energy that you have ever received. Your work is so appreciated. Allow this gift to swirl and whirl around you and envelope you with all it is intended to be. Your missions have been trying and difficult to watch, but you are forever amazing the onlookers of light with your forthright determination to bring peace and grace back into the earth plane. Bravo, bravo, bravo. All is in perfection and right on schedule. Peace and grace will return, my beloveds. It has a way to go, and certainly you have noticed how difficult it is to form consensus upon so many different beings. One's own inner struggle is really the biggest hurdle that must be surmounted by divine beings of grace. Remembrance of who you really are is very difficult for some to allow themselves to embrace. For you see, my beloveds, so many believe that they are still this physical vessel. You must understand that so many don't even like the physical vessel, let alone even begin to think that they are of a much higher origin. In these scenarios, the ego is just running rampant. Peace is not a concern for those that hate the physical body, who they think they are, to begin with. To these players, the war will rage for a very long, long time. Some may never come to grips with any other concept. Compassion, my beloveds, is needed. Love them anyway. They certainly don't love themselves, and they need love so desperately. Pray daily for all regardless, even if you doubt that they deserve your care and love. You are the way showers, the leaders, and the teachers. Your modeling of compassion and understanding is a portion of your mission. My beautiful beings of light, just when you think that you can take no more, invert your head to the heavens and ask for the strength to continue. Place your hands on your solar plexus and bow your head. In mental communication with your Creator, say, I am releasing to you now, my Creator, I am releasing to you now, my Creator, I am releasing to you now, my Creator, and so it is, my divine beings of light. A blanket of unconditional love will spiritually descend to enfold you and help you walk through the moment one step at a time. When you reach these types of breaking points, my beings of grace, you are struggling instead of just being and allowing. This is when you think that you are in control instead of walking in your guidance by listening to your spiritual heart. If you could remind yourselves that when you seemingly are running up against a brick wall, that by taking a deep breath you could bring in your guidance, then ask, what is this trying to show me? Struggle, pain, frustration, hurt and fear are your signals that you are not listening to your guidance. Take a step back, take a deep breath. Open your spiritual ears and release to your Creator to bring back in your guidance that you have been avoiding. Of course, that guidance probably wasn't saying what you wanted to hear, and that is precisely the reason that you shut it off to begin with, my beloveds. Allow this messenger to take you on a mediation journey. There is someone, the one closest to you, that you need to reacquaint yourself with. Find a quiet spot where you will not be disturbed for a while. You may either sit or lie down, whichever is more comfortable for you. Cover your physical self with a light blanket if you chill easily. You want no distractions during your meditations, so always make sure the physical vessel is comfortable. If it helps you to visualize by identifying your ego with a symbol or as an object, please do so. Direct your ego self to perch on your left shoulder. Instruct your ego self that it is only to be an observer on this journey. In your imagination, ask through prayer for the Creator to send you down a protective ray of white light by praying, my Creator, I am asking for a protective ray of white light to enfold me and lift me up so that I am experiencing the very highest of vibrations during this journey into my innermost depths of understanding and being. I am protecting myself from anything that is not for my highest good on this journey. I am thanking you, my Creator, for assisting me by sending this ray that is now coming down through the corner of the area where I am meditating. It is entering into this physical form, permeating all that is within this beingness presence, I am. The Creator has answered and has gifted you with an iridescent white ray plus a luminous magenta ray and iridescent pink ray for this journey. The rays are entering into your body through the soles of your feet and moving up through your physical vessel, permeating throughout all of your energy fields into all corners of the area that you are in, then exiting through your crown chakra. The rays are returning to the Creator and cycling back down through you again and back to the Creator in a circular motion. These rays are in a continuous circulating loop while you are in meditation. Visualize yourself using your breath to form a figure eight. The in-breath forms the top loop of the eight which goes over your head and your out-breath forms the bottom loop that goes under your feet. The middle of the eight is your waistline and forms the still point between the in-breath and the out-breath. It is forming the sign of infinity and it rhythmically continuing over and over again with each in-breath and out-breath. This is a reminder that you are infinitely guided throughout eternity. You are now divinely protected at this moment and nothing can even communicate with you that is not for your highest good without your permission. Breathe in deeply, my divine light beings, and feel the lighter, relaxed feelings of being divinely guided into this meditation. Breathe in deeply and know that you are breathing to the pulse of the Creator. Listen to the Creator's spiritual heartbeat and feel the unconditional love that courses through you each time you think about this moment. Breathe in deeply, allowing and seeing within your spiritual imagination your guardian angels and guides join you and take your etheric hand to direct you into your spiritual heart chakra. At this time, invite in all the spiritual guests that you would enjoy having accompany you on this journey. Your guardian angels, spirit guides and special invited guests are now within your spiritual heart chakra. You locate and turn the doorknob of the golden door that says to my highest guidance within. You cross over the threshold. You find yourself in a white marble corridor. Your angels tell you that you are to follow your heart as to which door to select as you walk down the corridor filled with all types of special rooms for your inner work. You walk for a while and then all of a sudden you are gently spiritually nudged to open the door to your left. The room seems to be rather dimly lit. The room itself is very large and the floor as you look down is wooden. The floor appears to be like those you have seen before when you went to dances and weddings. You go to the center of the dance floor because that is what seems to feel right. When you reach the exact spot, a mist appears. As you focus, you realize that the mist is taking shape. It appears very much like a candle flame with a faint blue hue. Concentrating further, you define a face. Guess what? It looks like you face. The beautiful flame essence has such a very strong energy emanating from it. Your hand tries to reach out and touch the face, but your hand finds nothing solid to connect with. Just then you hear the most wonderful musical laughter from this essence. Your angels smile and introduce you, once again, to your very own higher self. Your angels explain that this is the one closest to you, this is you. This is your real essence. Your higher self begins to speak to you and explain that the tiny spark that is wearing that physical vessel during this incarnation on the earth plane is but one minuscule part of this great essence. You are just a tiny particle carrying out a mission and reading lines from a script from a play called Earth. When you hear these words from your higher self, the remembrance dawns and confirms their truth. As this sinks in, you literally merge with the higher self essence. Oh! You say to yourself, this feels so right, so loving, and just as it should be. Reintegrating is coming home again, at least at this juncture. You realize instantly that this is not the complete home picture but a part. As you center within your true essence, the essence begins to swirl in joy around the floor. Reuniting is a time of great celebration. The music swells and wanes and swells again. At each crescendo, the connection feels more and more solid between you again. As you ponder this higher self reunion, it dawns on you what you have to look forward to when it is time to fully reunite with not only your higher essence but your heavenly home realm as well. Your angels and higher self smile at those thoughts. Your thought beams with knowingness, assuring you that when that moment comes, the spiritual trumpet will blow, the whole of heaven will rejoice on your return. Your return will be a monumental celebration for your graduation from Earth School. This brings such peace and tranquility to you. This reunion within this moment is such a blessing. It brings tears of great joy. The dancing slows as the higher self allows you to center and reconnect back with your separate entity. You stop at the very spot in the dance floor where you walked but a moment ago. Your higher self separates the two of you again. You are finding that you are saddened by this separation, but your higher self reminds you that you've got contracts to fulfill, a script to complete and a mission to finish. Your higher self also reminds you that the connection is not actually severed but only lessened enough so that you can function as an actor in the earth play. You are directed to keep your spiritual ears open so that the two of you can communicate always. Your higher self retract appearing once again as a mist and then vanishes. Your head just seems to bow as if you have lost your most treasured love. Your heart feels heavy and the tears of longing flow. Just at that moment within your thoughts your higher self's spiritual voice pops in, "Please do not cry, I am right here with you and love you so much. I am here, just listen for me and we will be able to communicate within this realm. You had just turned me off, that is all, I am here." The tears stop and the smile returns. Your angels gather around you and give you a big hug. They remind you it is all right, we are all here for you. It is time to return so that you can complete your work. You walk from the center of the dance floor and through the door, closing it behind you. You find you are back in the hall as you walk back into the white marble corridor. You thank your angels for guiding you on this journey. You notice how much lighter, more peaceful and centered you feel. You are now ready to resume your day. Your angels lead you back across the golden threshold door that leads you back into your spiritual heart chakra, and then they direct your spiritual essence back into your physical form. When you are ready, wiggle your fingers and toes and open your eyes. Go about your day remembering that your angelic support staff is always at your service, working with you to help you reach your highest and most appropriate potential. Always invite them in and thank them for their assistance. Your higher self is always there. Listen carefully to the guidance that pops into your awareness. Embrace an attitude of gratitude for all that you are. Beloveds, you are blessed beyond words and loved beyond measure, more than any earth plane language can ever express. I am Archangel Michael, the Creator's messenger of love, joy, wisdom, light, peace, and grace.